Leading Ladies, a Zambian podcast on historical women leaders. The assumption in our past has been women never played a part in pioneering missionary work in our history. In reality, some women have played important roles in both the evangelical and educational sector. Meet Helen Jengwera Nyirenda Kaunda, the evangelist teacher. Helen Kaunda was born Jengwera Nyirenda in the 1800s at Chisanya, near Ngoni village called Ekwendini in Malawi. Her father was Mugagana Nyirenda of the Henga ethnic group. Helen obtained her training as a school teacher at the Livingstonia Mission in Malawi, where she met and married David Julius Kaunda. In 1905, she accompanied her husband to what was then Northeastern Rhodesia to open a mission station and a school at Luwa in today's Chinsali district of Zambia. David Kaunda engaged in teaching, reading, and writing, as well as evangelizing to the local people and especially the men that could be trained as assistant teachers. Some of David Kaunda's students came to Chinsali school with their wives. As early as 1907, Helen started classes for the students' wives and taught home management, hygiene, child care, Bible lessons, reading and writing. She became the first African woman teacher in what was then called Northeastern Rhodesia. After 1914, special efforts for the advancement of women's education were implemented through the Women's Foreign Mission Committee of the Church of Scotland, WFM. In 1923, the WFM set up projects at Luwa to advance the position of women. Recognizing Helen Kaunda's experience and knowledge, the WFM put her in charge of the Luwa Women's School, making her the first African woman to head a school in what had by 1911 become Northern Rhodesia. By 1925, the school had 159 pupils and she was teaching at village schools within 5 miles of the mission station. In addition, the WFM activities included a women's group of 23 active volunteers offering Bible lessons to fellow women in the village. They became known as the Bible Women. This group also acted as a socio-economic network for women and became popular in the 1930s because the absence of men due to labor migration left many women sole providers for their households. In 1932, David Kaunda died. In 1934, a boarding school for girls opened at Luwa. Helen Kaunda, now a widow, became one of the first African women boarding mistresses in Northern Rhodesia. By 1935, the impact of the women's school could be seen by the reduction of infant mortality rates around the Luwa mission area. By the 1940s, the Luwa Bible Women organization spread to other areas and became known as Kafawawa Namayo Walusewa Kapepa, KBBK. Today, the KBBK is called the WCF under the United Church of Zambia. It is one of the largest and most influential church women's organizations in Zambia. Despite her achievements and dedication, Helen saw and experienced discrimination and injustice around her. She grew from being an obedient African missionary and teacher to a woman with her own voice and a strong opinion against what she experienced firsthand and considered unjust or unacceptable treatment of Africans by the colonial and missionary authorities. In 1953, Helen refused to take part in the celebration of the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II on 2nd June by refusing to plant a ceremonial coronation tree as a protest against colonial rule. In her own church, Helen Kaunda saw that African and European congregants worshipped at different times and sat in separate spaces in the church and did not racially interact. She became dissatisfied with the double standards of the missionaries who preached love and equality yet practiced racism and racial segregation within the church. Thoroughly disenchanted, Helen Kaunda left the Luwa church that her husband had established and that she had dedicated her life to and joined Alice Lenshina's Lumpa church, where her son Robert became a deacon. Helen Kaunda's youngest son, Kenneth David Kaunda became the first president of Zambia in 1964. She continued her good works and lived quietly at Lubwa until her death in 1973. Women have played important roles in both the evangelical and educational sectors.